proclamation was made by President Ronald Reagan, marking the first observance of the birthday of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. as a national holiday. He called it a time for rejoicing and reflecting, helping us to move closer to the ideals on which America was founded. Today, we honor Dr. King with speeches and monuments as he challenged Americans of every race and creed and color to work together to build in this blessed land a shining city of brotherhood, justice, and harmony. This is the monument Dr. King would have wanted most of all.
During the 1993-94 school year, a diverse group of parents whose children attended Orchard Lake Middle School met to discuss a variety of issues and ideas. This multicultural awareness committee was endorsed by Esther Peterson, principal of the school.
The multicultural committee wanted to make a difference in the community. This was an active group. They wanted the community to have an appreciation for diversity. Therefore, I encouraged them to go to the school board and state the reasons why this would bring our whole community together.
Several concerned parents, with the support of the entire group, went before the West Bloomfield Board of Education and requested that the school district close in honor of the Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Day.
Good evening, boards, members of the board, Dr. Gretschko. I am Diane Ferguson. I am here this evening to read a letter to you from the Orchard Lake Middle School Multicultural Awareness Committee.
Well, the letter itself was very concise. After all, this was already a national holiday, and I wanted the board to understand the urgency of our request. And I also wanted them to remember that they, as well as the rest of the citizens in West Bloomfield, had benefited from Dr. King's works, what he had lived for, what he had died for. So it was time for us to stop and pay homage to someone who had done so much for so many in such a short period of time.
When Diane Ferguson and I went before the West Bloomfield School Board 10 years ago, neither of us really knew what to expect. Personally, I was a little afraid that we might meet with some ambivalence, but after a short discussion, a few questions and answers, every one of those school board members stepped up to the plate and they did what was right. It was a proud day for all of us.
It's been moved and supported that Martin Luther King Day be a day of observance, and that observance be characterized by non-attendance of both students and staff. Do I understand the motion correctly, Mr. Tobin?
Correct.
Is there all in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? The motion carries 6-0 with Mrs. Lipton absent.
President of the West Bloomfield School Board, Jeffrey Stewart, reacted to the proposal.
I remember at the time when we heard about the idea of dedicating a day to Martin Luther King that this is a good idea. What I didn't appreciate then was how big an idea it would become. I think unconsciously I thought this will be a day for minorities in our community to celebrate a great civil rights hero. And what it quickly became was a day for all of us to celebrate a great American hero who had taught us values of tolerance and acceptance and forgiveness that transcend race. That to me has been the great development of Martin Luther King Day. It started as one thing and has grown into something so much bigger.
And bigger it was. As the group's commitment deepened, Hertha Woodruff felt the need to suggest they orchestrate a community-wide event.
The timing was perfect to launch a multicultural event in West Bloomfield, Michigan. We were very diverse. In fact, we still are. I propose that at the first Martin Luther King Day off, a community walk that would be both harmonious and inclusive of everyone.
And Dr. Gretschko, as superintendent, I remember sat at the table and smiled to himself, really. And this was right. It is time. We should take a position. We should be leaders. And under his leadership, United We Walk was started.
Thank you.
also endorsed the idea of a community-wide event.
Well, I remember that day exactly. I had to call Dr. Gretschko, and I know that this event was going to entail a walk down Orchard Lake, perhaps a day off school, and quite a few other things. And when I called, I got this great response. Sure, I think that'd be a great idea. And Dr. Gretschko, I think in the spirit of Dr. King and in the spirit of the community, said, great, let's go.
Sharkey Haddad suggested that clergy become involved as well.
And I thought that if we reach out to the West Bloomfield clergy, that not only we will get them involved in the walk, but also their followers in their congregations will look at them as role models, and they will also be encouraged to participate in the walk.
Having grown up and the time that Dr. King was alive, and feeling that it was important that that be remembered, and bringing that to a new generation as well, I think that's why we all were involved and why it was so important to get it started in that way.
Haddad also originated the name for the event.
I was involved with the Ross Perot campaign for the United States presidency, and his theme was United We Stand. So I figured if we come up with a name such as United We Walk, it will send a double message in the greater West Bloomfield area.
Kenyell Ferguson and Crystal Roberson came up with the winning logo.
What Kenyell had in mind when designing the logo for United We Walk was something simple, as well as something that symbolized an unbroken circle of unity and brotherhood in the community.
Well, I had four school-aged children in the district. I was on a multicultural committee, and I felt that it was my duty to help. The buttons, I'm in the promotional products business, and being on the committee, they said, well, can you get us some buttons? Of course I did.
It's a memorable thing to do for all the things that he lived and died for.
Events of this magnitude depend extensively on the support of the community. School board member and general co-chair Beth Borson contacted area businesses for their support.
The response was extremely positive. We were fortunate that we have a strong community ties. Town Hall was very helpful under Jetty Hood's support. The clergy came on board, and local businesses also. I'm involved in real estate, and my company became involved as well as others.
The Optimist Club of West Bloomfield was an early sponsor of United We Walk because the United We Walk exemplifies the ideals of Dr. Martin Luther King and shows that our community cares about those ideals.
Well, we were really fortunate to be asked to be one of the sponsors, and we helped get out publicity regarding the new event in our community. And now we've been fortunate that we're working from the viewpoint that we're maintaining the website to keep it up to date.
Borson was also responsible for the official banner that has become so recognized in association with United We Walk. Probably one of the most complicated responsibilities of the walk committee was coordinating procedures and logistics for the 30-minute walk down Orchard Lake Road from Orchard Lake Middle School to West Bloomfield High School.
Particularly the first event entailed getting permits from Oakland County in order to close Orchard Lake Road and just for the permit itself for that number of people, which was about 1,000 people that we had the first walk. It took about 45 minutes, 50 minutes, I believe, for us to walk down there. And it was a little bit of an inconvenience. Obviously, Orchard Lake Road is a busy street, but I think everybody was in good spirits. Rerouting traffic, it was an effort through the community, the schools, and the police department that was tremendously successful, I thought.
And General Motors donated vans to the United We Walk, because what we had to do, the walk started at Orchard Lake Middle School and went to the high school. My wife had been diagnosed with breast cancer the year before, in 1993, and she was just ending her initial treatment and some of the chemotherapy when Hertha Woodruff came to her and asked her to serve on the United We Walk, the walk committee itself. And I have to say that that was probably one of the best things that happened until she had been through her treatment, and she, even though she was still weak, she really took this project on with vigor, like I'd never seen her do anything else.
Even at the elementary level, kids got involved.
I recall the first United We Walk as a joining together of students and staff, parents and community to honor the memory of a man that truly changed the face of America. My fondest memory is of the all-elementary choir singing a tribute to Dr. Martin Luther King before an auditorium overflowing with people. There truly wasn't a dry eye in the house.
Well, we had made a decision to do some parent education, and we had parents coming in and discussing and telling us about their culture. So that's one way that we started.
Well, adhering to the philosophy of the International Club, students pledged to commit their time and effort to learning about various cultural and ethnic groups within our community. So what the students did in this club is they promoted the event within the school and try to motivate students to join the event, come to the walk, participate in the day's activity, so that they would have a better understanding of Martin Luther King, his goals and ideals, and what he stood for.
As an International Club member, Michael Schoenberger describes the impact that United We Walk has had on his life.
And about heroes, and everyone who comes to this event, everyone who thinks that it's important, is inspired, you know, by Dr. King, and what's more, by people who do this event.
Many students were selected as walk monitors to help with the event.
You know, in our community, we're very fortunate that our students and our families believe in giving back. So anytime we have a program or an occasion, all we need to do is go to the clubs and the organization and invite students to be a part of. Little did we know at that time that we're inviting students to be a part of a historical moment in the West Bloomfield School District. So it was a matter of going to National Honor Society, going to the athletic team, going to the other clubs and organizations, and seeing who wanted to raise their hand to be a part of this opportunity to really be ambassadors for our school as we saw them at the time, because we didn't know the magnitude which this program was going to take for the day. The community an opportunity to see our students in a different light once they came into the building that looked so massive off of Orchard Lake Road.
About 30 minutes before the walk began, I think I was dropped off at my walk monitor's location, kind of at the corner of the high school in Orchard Lake. I just remember waiting and waiting, not seeing any people, and you knew there were people at Orchard Lake Middle School. You start seeing people come over the hill, and more people come over the hill, and it was just amazing. As I mean, people were all the way up at the high school and can still see people walking over the hill. A ton of people showed up at the end, and just seeing all those people walking for the one event for the first time that had ever happened, it was really an exciting time and really an exciting event.
Well, Prince of Peace was given the task of walking at the end of the walk, our parishioners. We carried some garbage bags and some picker-uppers, and we were supposed to pick the styrofoam cups up that people might accidentally drop along their way from the middle school to the high school. But as it turned out, people didn't drop their things along the side of the road. I think probably we took that job. Maybe we heard someplace along the line that the last shall be first.
publicity was important to promote the event.
A wide variety of media were used. We actively used flyers and posters all over the community. The mailers went home with all of the students, especially those at the high school and elementary. And we did actively connect with network TV media through the contacts of Shirley Mitchell Rogers. We also had wonderful promos designed by Andy Groen for the school district channel, and they also played on Civic Center 15, which is the local government channel as well.
I feel like we did a very meaningful, useful part, that is to make the Asian guests feel instantly at home and welcome and connect. I think we have quite a good representation of Asian community, like Chinese, Japanese, and Indian, and I feel we did a contribute.
My responsibility on that morning was to greet people at the door and welcome them and have them sign in and pass the program to them and direct them to the cafeteria.
Hospitality abounded. Walkers were provided with a complimentary brunch in the high school cafeteria.
We decided that we wanted to be the chairpersons for the breakfast committee. We went to different restaurants, and all the restaurants in the area were unbelievable. They all responded. They were all very enthusiastic about the idea. It turned out that it was not just the breakfast. It turned out being a brunch. Bagels and cream cheese, donuts. We had Chinese food.
Well, we knew we needed a warm-up because it was kind of brisk that morning, and so I volunteered to go on up and get us started. And I remembered we were playing some pretty lively music. The specific one was Celebration. And we were young folk, old folk, everybody was just gathered around, and it was just wonderful. It was a celebration.
United We Walk received a very special endorsement.
I actually contacted Coretta Scott King's office. We congratulated United We Walk on our efforts and, of course, wished us much success in our continuation for many years to come.
The program in the auditorium following the walk capped off the day.
When the program was about to begin, it was my job to get people rounded up and seated and ready to go.
District media staff played a huge role in ensuring technically that the program came off without a hitch.
Well, being the auditorium coordinator at that time, we'd never done an event with this magnitude, with this much community involvement before. And there was a lot of people that were involved in it, and it was a bit chaotic. And what's funny about live theater, because this is live theater, is that you look at what's going on and you're not sure if this thing is actually going to, you know, pull all together. And it did pull all together.
Packed up my camera and zoomed down to the high school to assist with them coming in and filming them as they came in. Put the camera away and helped the folks with last minute microphone requests. Cords, chairs on stage.
A lot of multimedia going on at the time. So for television, live performance, it was really an amazing technical event, really.
And they had some general ideas for a visual to kind of be the logo. And we just kind of fine-tuned it and worked it around so that it was something that everybody liked. And I think the current logo today has pretty much the makings of what we started with, I guess, 10 years ago.
West Bloomfield Township Supervisor Jetty Hood had a surprise when she greeted the audience.
You should see what I see from here. You should see the multitude of faces. You should see the colors. This is truly a miracle.
And I had made
a supposition that this event was going to be embraced primarily by our African-American families in West Bloomfield. And when I got up there and I approached the podium, the first words I said, if you could see what I see. And what I saw was every color of the rainbow. People, old people, young people, people not involved with the schools, people not involved with government, just people, but a real spectrum of individuals. And it made me very happy.
Speaking on behalf of the West Bloomfield Board of Education, I was pleased and proud to realize that we had been instrumental in bringing the Dr. Martin Luther King holiday to West Bloomfield, as the board has always been a staunch proponent of diversity, and this was an excellent way to show it.
Well, the meaning of the song was so clear to the occasion. We are the world, we are the children. I felt that they would make a better place to live in, provided they're taught through the message of Dr. King. If we teach them well, we won't have to unteach.
And can you feel the love tonight? It is where we are.
It is where we are.
Is enough for this wide-eyed wanderer that we got this far.
I selected Can You Feel the Love Tonight from The Lion King, because for me it represented the reason for gathering on that afternoon 10 years ago. However, it also represented the feeling of love and the spirit that came alive.
There's a time for everyone if they only learn that the twisting kaleidoscope moves us all in turn. There's a rhyme and reason to the world outdoors. When the heart of this star-crossed voyager beats in time with yours.
Terry Gianetti's real-life experiences speak of basic human rights and freedoms.
Having lived in Saudi Arabia for 6 years and worked there, I really believe that's another level of cultural diversity. I thought I was very open-minded and accepting of other cultures and free of prejudices, and what I found is that I wasn't. Probably all of us have some kind of prejudice that we grow up with because of our background, but the important part is that I learned that every culture impacts you as a person, as a society, and a culture has a right to believe what they believe. And it may not be the tradition that I may want, but I've become very accepting to the fact that my way may not be the right way for everyone, just as someone else's way may not be the right way for me. And that pushed my edge, and I'm very proud to say that I learned a lot.
Well, in West Bloomfield, it was more magnified, the diversity that we have, and the committee was very forward-thinking 10 years ago to come up with United We Walk, and we were just very proud to be a part of it.
Brotherhood and diversity were the religious leaders' topics that brought true meaning to the efforts of a dedicated community.
Right here in West Bloomfield, we carry the ageless message of brotherhood into a new generation. It must happen in every part of our lives, in our schools, in our places of work, and most importantly, within the walls of our homes.
When I had an opportunity to speak to the community on Martin Luther King Day, it was a great chance to share with them a message of what it means to be members of one community living together. The idea of brothers and sisters, albeit of different races and religions, living together is something that all of us can learn from and use to better our community.
Out of one blood, God made the diversity of the human family. Different colors, different tongues, different dialects. He made man, he made the human family, and he made them to be one.
Well, diversity means to me inclusion. It means oneness, it means wholeness, it means unity. And I believe that West Bloomfield is an example of a community in America where there's a different diversity of persons who express by their living together, by their working together, by their community involvement, what diversity really is. I had the privilege of walking with our former school superintendent, Dr. Greshkel, and he shared with me his concerns about our community and what he thought it really was and could become. And to him, it was a great place, and I had the privilege of, one of the things that he shared with me was that he believes that if families were made whole and that there was a healthy father, a healthy mother, and a healthy relationship with children, that would be reflected in our system and we would be a better community.
Of all of the growth that United We Walk has experienced in terms of its program and format and audience, nothing has been more exciting than the inclusion of students from across Metro Detroit. Where else could you find the troubadours from Wall Lake and the Allen Park Jazz Band on the same stage, or students from Detroit and Sterling Heights and Lakeland in a small group discussion talking about diversity or segregation in the lunchroom, or affirmative action, or interracial dating? Only at United We Walk.
West Bloomfield, as a community, should share great pride in the leadership that Dr. Greshko displayed, that the Board of Education, that we continue to expand, be an educational day, a day to reflect, and a day to honor.